Atlantis was built on an island, perhaps as big as Australia, that has since sunk below the waves. And Plato gives an extensive description of its geography. The land, he says, provided its people with everything. Flocks of various kinds fed on its lush meadows. Timber and other metals were found in abundance, among which was a precious material that Greeks knew only by name, orichalcum, that Plato assures Atlantis had in large quantities. Animals of different kinds roamed the countryside, and even elephants were to be found in large numbers. Exotic fruits now hard to find, liquid gum and cocoa palms, pomegranates and citrus were also found in abundance, and Atlantis enjoyed the innumerable goods of their island paradise. The capital city was a marvel to behold, built in perfect concentric circles of land, where water moats connected with bridges leading to the royal palace, a palace that each successive king had improved during his reign, until it had become an abode of magnitude and beauty. The outermost circle of the city opened to a channel, big enough for the largest vessels to pass. From afar, Atlanteans could see merchant ships from across the world carrying their goods, while minor waterways were opened to connect every part of the city in a single network of distribution. Towers were built from stones that were white, black, and red, weaving the colors together with natural grace. And just like Athens had its celebrated temple of Athena, the Parthenon, the Acropolis of Atlantis was devoted to Poseidon, the sea god, from whose sons its kings were descended.